Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with StarTree. The world is a place where things go wrong. And when they do, you want to find out about it as soon as possible, and you want to know why, so you can take action to fix the problem. That is the heart and soul of anomaly detection. Let's take a look at the life cycle of an anomaly. So, out in the world, some bad thing happens. We don't know what it is. I'm sure you can fill in the blank in terms of your business and what you do. We'll just draw a frowny face. There is some anomaly out in the world. Now, you don't know yet that that has happened. That's a little bit of a chilling thought. So some amount of time goes by before you actually know. We'll call that the mean time to detect. All right. And then once we know that that anomaly has happened, we start to, let's draw a little magnifying glass here. We start to look into things and investigate the cause of the anomaly, right? We're going to go through some kind of process here until we discover what that is. We'll say this is our root cause analysis going on. And then at this point, we know what has happened. And so we'll just draw a little light bulb, a little old school light bulb, the filament in there. We understand what has gone wrong, and then we can go on to fix the problem, and life is better. So here's kind of the life cycle. Now, there are some problems with the way this normally goes down, and that is, for one, this process typically involves batch data and batch analytics happening in historical systems, the way they've been built, and it is manual. It involves at least one human, likely, doing that. And it doesn't handle multidimensional data very well. What I mean there, typically this anomaly detection happens because that person, this human right here, is probably looking at a dashboard, right? Dashboards are human anomaly detection instruments. And so you look at graphs on a dashboard, you get used to what the wiggles look like. Suddenly the wiggles look a little different and you say, wait, something has gone wrong. That gets you here and you can kick off the analysis and root cause detection stuff, right? So in the typical case, you've got these batch data sources feeding dashboards. There's a human anomaly detector looking at that data. So that's inefficient, kind of a bad use of time. And again, with highly dimensional data, this just isn't going to work. Because you can imagine, say, aggregate sales or aggregate web traffic or some single dimensional measurement like that. Okay, I know what it's supposed to look like and I can learn when it looks different. I can be that anomaly detector. But what about when it's sales in Brazil and people who are using the Brave browser or whatever, and you start to add some dimensions and suddenly you've got a dashboard filled with dozens of graphs to look at and one person trying to memorize what all those look like. My goodness, that's dystopian, right? So it doesn't work well for multidimensional data. You can be a human anomaly detector. It's inefficient, but you really fall down on highly dimensional data. So there are problems with that in the historical approach. It gets worse because down here during this root cause analysis phase, after we've learned that the anomaly exists, we're trying to look for what the cause is, there are probably lots and lots of people involved, right? Especially if it's a consequential anomaly that has a significant impact on the business, everybody is dropping what they're doing and getting involved in the root cause analysis. Very, very expensive. This can potentially take days, right? We don't know. And probably these relatively highly optimized batch processes that were creating this dashboard that this sort of dystopian human anomaly detector set off the alarm with here, probably those batch processes aren't giving us what we need to solve the problem. There may be whole new batch analysis jobs that need to be created, submitted, run. And so this can take a lot of time and be very manual. And in general, it's just very expensive to do. And that gets us eventually at our root cause analysis, which again, from there leads to a fix. Now, it's really this part of the process that we want to look at how to automate, right? Now, from here on out, how to fix it, that does just take humans being insightful, solving problems, looking, improvising, whatever it is, fixing problems in the world. That's why we have jobs. But this stuff, seems ripe for automation. And the stakes are high. Let's talk about kind of the costs here as we go through this anomaly. We'll just draw a little chart and we'll say this is time and this is money. If we could think of the overall value in the business is decaying when something is broken, right? Your ability to execute transactions with customers or, you know, whatever it is you do is going to go down, right, over time. And there are going to be these certain milestones here. So to bring in our points in the life cycle here, this, of course, is when something goes wrong in the world. This is when we become aware of it. You know, we've already suffered, you know, a loss of some kind of value here before we even know there's a problem. And then it takes some more time where we've lost even more value before we know what to do. And, you know, we have that insight that enables us to execute on a fix. This is bad. All this shaded area here, that's money that just evaporates because we didn't know something was broken and it took us a long time to figure out. So that is the heart and soul and the motivating factor behind automated anomaly detection, like what StarTree ThirdEye does. So that's super important. There's something even scarier, though, before we finish, that I want to just point out, that there's really this kind of black hole in the middle here, shown in green in this case, of the anomalies that you don't even know have happened. So these are the ones that become visible in the old manual way because there's a dashboard and there's a person looking at the wiggles on the dashboard who has trained their brain to recognize the change. There are things that go wrong that then maybe right themselves after a while that you never even know about. And without multidimensional, automated, real-time anomaly detection in place, you never will know about those. So if this isn't scary enough, the stuff that you don't even know has gone wrong really is another factor. So this is why it's important that we rethink the way we handle anomaly detection. You have to think, every time you've got a dashboard and a person watching it, you're just training that person to be a human anomaly detector. And that fundamentally is not a solution that's going to work going forward. This is a thing ripe for automation so that those people can be freed up to take place in the repair of the problem. Problems are still going to happen. And these folks need to be free to do this insightful creative activity over here. And we want machines doing that stuff as much as possible. If you want to know more about StarTree's solution to this problem, you should check out ThirdEye. ThirdEye is our automated anomaly detection and root cause analysis tool that runs on top of Apache Pinot. And if you want to take it for a spin, you can do that. Just go to startree.ai and click free trial, and you can check it out for free. I look forward to seeing what kind of anomalies you find that you hadn't even known about before.